Yo, 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 what is going on YouTube? I hope you're all doing just fine today. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Gillian Nova, and for today's video, I'm gonna show you how to install the brand new RTX 3070 from NVIDIA and Gigabyte. So let's get this video started. So first things first, if you purchased the 3070, the 3080, or the 3090, I just wanna say congratulations to you guys. And for those of you who aren't aware, it is pretty hard to purchase these right now. I was lucky enough to purchase mine off Newegg for MSRP price of $549. Also, it was just recently released on October 29th, 2020. So I believe it's gonna be really hard to purchase these until maybe next spring or next summer of 2021. Without further ado, let's go see what's inside this box. Before we continue the unboxing and installation of the RTX 3070, please hit the like button down below as it helps my small channel grow. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, and if you have any questions, please leave a comment below, or you can reach me on Instagram at Gillianova. All right, so let's go see what's inside the box. Not sure what's inside here. Looks like it's like some warranty, and is this a quick guide? And then right underneath that, we have the graphics card. Okay, let's open it. It says right here, Gigabyte qualified. And this right here is the brand new RTX 3070 by Gigabyte. So here is a close-up of the RTX 3070 from Gigabyte and NVIDIA. On the top right corner, we can see here an 8+6 pin. This is going to connect to your PSU, also known as your power supply unit. This is going to be helpful later on in this video. And on the side right here, we have a DisplayPort, HDMI, another DisplayPort, and another HDMI. On the very bottom, this is going to connect to your motherboard. So please keep note of that for later on in this video. So now I'm going to put this aside. The very next step is to turn off your computer so that we can install your brand new graphics card. Alright YouTube, so this is my current graphics card. This is the 2070 Super Mini from Zotac Gaming. As I mentioned, on the 3070, we have an 8+6 pin right here. We're going to pull that out. Next, we're going to unscrew our old graphics card so that we're able to pull it out. Alright YouTube, so next we're going to pull out our graphics card. There should be a latch on the very top. You're just gonna push down and hear it click, and you should be able to pull out your graphics card. Underneath your graphics card, you should see two more slots right here. It's not focusing right now. This is the same exact latch as your graphics card. You're just gonna push down on it, and then you're gonna pull the graphics card out. All right, so we're gonna push down the latch, and we're gonna pull out our graphics card. And then zooming in, you can see the latch right there. Alright, so now we're going to place our brand new graphics card on the same slot. So as I mentioned earlier, these pins are going to connect to your PCIe slot right here. So just align that with that slot. Once that's aligned, push it in, and you should hear it click like that. Next, we're going to screw our graphics card on the corner so that it's not loose. Next, grab our cables from our power supply unit. As you can see right here, this is the 8 pin. And then right here is a 6+2 pin. As you can see right here, there's a clip on the very top. It's going to attach right here. All right, so we're gonna go with the 8 pin first. And then the 6 pin. All right, so now just put the cover back and all the cables that you had attached to the back of your computer, especially the power supply unit, USBs, display ports, and HDMI. Alright YouTube, so now that we have our computer turned on, we're gonna go to NVIDIA's website, we're gonna go to drivers, GeForce drivers, click on that, then just select download now, and then once that's downloaded, we're gonna open up our file. You can see right here, it's downloading right now. Agree and install, so it's gonna take some time. Alright, so now that that's done, we're gonna select drivers, download, and as you can see here, it was recently released. Today it is December 7th. Alright YouTube, so as you can see on my screen right here, the graphics card driver is successfully installed. All you need to do now is to restart your computer and everything should be good to go. So if you thought this video was very helpful for you, please hit the like button down below. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment below or you can reach me on Instagram @Gilianova. Until next time YouTube, stay gold.